الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم من همزه ونفثه ونفثه. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله القر الميامين وعلى صحابته المدلفين بالدستور وعلى من استنى سنتهم وانتهج بمنهجهم ولف بلفهم لا يلقى الله الأرض ومن عليها وإلى الله عاقبة الأمور. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most exalted, the most high, the uncreated but creator of all creations, the unsustained and sustainer of everything. We appreciate him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for having made it given, inshallah, to all of us as an effort of the part of this congregation. We can never ever thank him enough. We only believe in the messenger of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to show his blessings upon the noble son of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, members of his household, companions, and the generality of Muslims in the day of recompense. Ameen. Respected elders, brothers and sisters alike, today inshallah kareem, our sermon is with a topic, Al-Muslimun wa khuturatu tasannifi al-mi'awi. Al-Muslimun wa khuturatu tasannifi al-mi'awi. Muslims and the danger of 50-50 syndrome. Allahu Akbar. Muslims and the danger of 50-50 syndrome. Respected elders, brothers and sisters alike, this is a topic that affects all of us in one way or the other, but it affects men mostly, especially youth and those elderly, those who are still marrying. Allahu Akbar. 50-50 syndrome has become a household name in among the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It used to be a concept from among the Jews, among those who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either capitalist, socialist, whatever list you belong to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you your own list. And that list of Allah is perfectly made. Allahu Akbar Kabir. It is a way, 50-50 syndrome is a way or a cunning way of luring women into accepting or taking a responsibility of half or 50% of what happens in the household, in the marriages. Allahu Akbar. In fact, it is so worse to the extent that some men today make that a precondition for women before marrying them. Allahu Akbar Kabir. This is part of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about. Wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. Allah swears by time that that time shall come, therein, innal insana lafi khusr. Mankind is in a state of quagmire, is in a state of loss, except those who believe in Allah and they match, they match make their own iman alongside their good deeds. Allahu Akbar. These are the people who will be accepted. May Allah make you and I from among them. This condition, today, where we have found ourselves in, it is in a head-on collision with the injunction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Sunnah Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah told you and I in Surah 2 An-Nisa, verse 34, Ar-Rijalu Qawwamuna 'ala An-Nisa. That is the system of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You and I are not invited to review either upward or to review downward the system made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Ar-Rijalu Qawwamuna 'ala An-Nisa. Men are in charge of women. Bima faddala Allahu ba'dahum 'ala ba'd.
By virtue of the right, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives some above others. وَبِمَا أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. And by virtue of what they spend from their money for upkeep and sustenance of women. Allahu Akbar. That is the injunction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning, being a married man, it is your sole responsibility to feed your wife, to clothe her, to give her shelter, to do everything for your children. Not the 50-50 syndrome that we see today. Men today have to get their own responsibilities. Some believe, no, it is 50-50. You pay school fees, I pay this wage bill, never bill. Some say, no, I will buy clothes for children during Karamin Salah. You will buy children their clothes for Baban Salah. I will pay this, our excursion. You will pay that. That is not Sunnah of Allah. Never will that be Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Many people under that, those who are doing 50-50% syndrome, they technically and divinely, subtly invite poverty into their lives. They subtly, out of their corny mind, their myopic thinking, that after all, I work, you work. You get salary, I get salary. At the end of the day, you have to bring something to the table. In fact, some brothers will tell you today, if a lady is not going to bring anything to the table, let her continue to live under the roof of her father. Allahu Akbar Kabir. Allah is giving you the ecosystem. The system of Allah is that ar-rijalu qawwamuna 'ala an-nisa. Men are in charge of women. Don't make women to be in charge of you. Don't think you are perfectly doing it. Something, no. Hi, I have to make my money. I have to do that. No. Whatsoever you are going to make, if you feed your wife, you clothe your wife, you shelter your wife, you provide everything based on the requirement, and then the little means Allah has given to you, you tend to get more from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during the farewell pilgrimage, he says, Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra, ya ma'ashara shabab, all you that are present here, and all elderly ones, Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra, be caring for your children, for your wife, take good care of your wife, be generous to your wives, be kind to your wives, be nice to your wives. Istawsu bin nisa'i khayra, your wives are never made slaves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bima faddala ba'dahu, faddala Allahu ba'dahu ala ba'd. It is a system of Allah that you are in charge. Take fully charge of that and then never you compromise. In another hadith of Imam Bukhari, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, khayrukum, khayrukum li ahli. The best of men are those who are best in their families, in the sight of Allah, Allahu Akbar. Wa ana khayrukum li ahli. I'm the best of all of you because I'm the best to my family. Then look inward into the household of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What made him the best for you and I to take a lesson? And what made the wife of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be submissive? We take that for you and I to know, why are you getting it wrong? Because you must pay dearly for every arrogance against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah says this, when you think in your own right way, you can do this, definitely, definitely, you can never, ever have a good alternative to that of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you have chosen that way, you will come back and pay dearly. It might be late. May Allah never make it late for all of us. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this, what is a woman representing in your own house or in your own life? In authentic hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no matter how rich you are, if you don't have wife at all, and you are mature, you are Muslim, you are saved, nothing is wrong with you, neither faculty, nor your job, nothing, then you are not among those who are praised by Prophet Sallallahu. In fact, you have been condemned, underlying it. Prophet Sallallahu says, Shirarukum, Anzabukum, the worst of my ummah are the bachelors. Not said by me, said by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Who are those bachelors? You have your work, you have your good thing, but you want to have your house before you get married. You want to ride a Lamborghini before you get married. You want to own one big car before this and that. All these things are ma'an sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are making those difficulties to yourself, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is one. for you to ever remain on the same page with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you streamline whatsoever your degree, you streamline whatsoever your second degree, third degree, professorship, everything. You have to make them in consonance, in tandem with the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Doing that alone gives you rest of mind in dunya, gives you a place in Al-Jannah in Akhira. May Allah make it easier for all of us. A woman is ja'ala Allahu al-mar'a sakana li zawjiha rahmatan. Allah ta'ala makes a woman, your wife, sakanan, a tranquility for you in your life. As Allah says in many verses of the Quran, Suratu At-Tawbah, Suratu An-Nisa, Suratu Al-A'raf, Suratu Rum. Let's take that Suratu Rum. When Allah ta'ala says, He, Allah ta'ala, has created from among yourselves your own wife, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا, so that wherever you go to work, you come back in peace and meet peace and tranquility at home. وَجَعْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. Allah, Allah has made between you مَوَدَّة, love, affection, وَرَحْمَةً, and mercy. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً. That's part of the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that Allah has chosen for you. But some people believe today, I'm married to a very wrong person. If she is wrong to you, perhaps double check, you might also be wrong to me, to her. But in reality is that you are not wrong. You are not the wrong candidate. She is not the wrong candidate. Something is missing. Right from the beginning, you check, double check. In fact, triple check, fourth check, fifth check. Check within yourself. Were there some promises you have made when she was outside? How far have you gone in fulfilling those promises? Have you called yourself what you were not up to at the time she was coming in? That's another problem for some brothers. My father is so Al-Qadi, and then he has so company, this and that, whereas his father is nobody, just Abdullah. God say, my brother, one of them is the head of Sheraton. Another one is the head of FPA. Another one is the PA to Malami. Another one is a TA to Pantami, this and that, just to get the woman. Whoever marries or born fortunate, that marriage will not last. Nobody is attacking you, and nobody is dressing you. Some will believe it's from my family, from my village. No. You got it wrong from the beginning. And getting it wrong from the beginning, then you pay dearly for it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us what we are expected to do. Al-Rijalu Qawwamun ala Nisa. Prophet told us, Istausu bin Nisa'i Khayra. He told us again, Khayrukum li Ahli, wa ana Khayrukum li Ahli. These are samples, as Allah says, Laqad kana lakum fi Rasulillahi uswatun hasana. The best practices, the best of manners, the best of characters are embedded, inshallah, in the personality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Only you and I, if you follow, fine. If you refuse, you obey them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to be our guide. Number two, the Surah presence love, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made women for you as to get better life and then better of akhirah. Why? She's coming to give you half of your religion. But people mistake or deliberately and twist this half of religion to half of responsibility. Pay 50%, I pay 50%. I will pay school fees of my children, you will pay Islamia fee. I will buy something for your mother, you buy something for your father in my name. All these things, man, Allah, we are missing God. Don't lower yourself. Don't bring yourself down. Allah has elevated you. That is the sunnah of Allah. If you have a woman who is richer than you, and she is helpful, and she is doing that willingly, that is for you. But don't coerce her. Don't force her. Just like in the case of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he married Khadija, Khadija was buoyant, very rich, in fact, richer than Prophet Sallam by far. But she brought her money, her wealth, everything, including her life, her heart. She donated everything to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you are so lucky to have that, you can never have something equivalent to that of Rasulullah. You can never have it. But if you have your own way, then kunsha kirallillah. Be giving thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if a woman is working and say, no, I have to do this, you have to do that, that's your own sunnah, not the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In hadith of Abu Huraira, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked by Muawiyah bin Haydah. Muawiyah bin Haydah said, Ya Rasulullah, ma haqqu ahdina ala zawjati. What is the responsibility of we men on our women? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, simple. An tut'imaha idha tu'inda. Feed her when you feed. Meaning, the same thing you eat, you give her. Watabsuha idha tasaita. Give her good clothes as you wear good clothes. Wala tadrib alwajha. Don't slap your wife. The association of wife beaters, if you are here, take a lesson from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not a good attribute of a Muslim. La tadrib alwajha. Don't slap your wife. Meaning, don't beat your wife at all. Don't beat your wife. There are people, once they come, the wife will be crying already if she hears the sound that the car has arrived. The one in the morning will be different from the afternoon, will be different from night, and she is very responsible outside. But to his wife, it's like drowning. Wallahi, I don't know anybody. But cases are all over. I've always told us, just go to Sharia court. Either in Kubwa, in Gudu, go and see messy cases. See somebody with company, even has a lot of everything allergic to him. But when it comes to marital affairs, it's far away. Somebody, how will you hang your babariga? You remove the cloth, you remove everything. You have already served you. The next thing is to enter and lock yourself and her, and you start beating her inside your room. Wallahi la'adhim. So the extent that some, the children will come out, say, Baba, Baba, Yahi Yahwa, leave the mother, mother, mama, very okay, mumuche, this and that. It is never a good attribute of a Muslim. La tadrib bil wajha, don't slap her. Wala tukat bihi, don't even abuse her. Kutu mame, nene, this and that. You are not expected to do that. Even for the sake of the children, that is enough. For the sake of the first night, that you had, that if somebody had told you not to marry her, you would have brought the heaven and heart and submerged them together. The same woman now today, she is nobody. Fear Allah, as Rasul Salam says, Instausu bin Nizaim Khairah. Be kind to your women, your wives, and fear Allah. In another hadith, Allah, fil Nizar, Prophet Salam said, fear Allah, in the way and manner you treat your women. Naturally, and circumventually, some women are stubborn. Put the boy in bracket. But as an elder, as a man, as a responsible brother who believes in the way of Prophet Sallam, you are expected to do your own need. Then, if that should be the case, you have done your own need, and she is continuing to do that which Allah Subhanahu wa Taala has forbidden her from, then you don't have any problem if you give her hours. Yet, in the way of Allah, in the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, ja'ala nikah. Part of what are the causes of this 50-50 syndrome today? What are the causes? You said some people don't do this. Why are people still doing it? The fault is yours, the fault is mine. Especially our elders, Muslim community. Number one is ja'ala nikah ghali. Making nikah today, materialistically expensive. Allah shall query you, because when you married your own wife, they collected little because you had little. Today people are passing in front of your house, you have grown-up women, 5, 6, 7, all of them are graduates, nobody has come to knock your door. There is problem. If they are materialistically upfront and they are inclined, that is also in the parents, there will be a problem. That problem today, we are not seeing. A lot, in doing that, we are not legalizing zina. You sleep at 10 p.m., 11 p.m., your daughters are still chatting with men outside till 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. They don't have any God to come together as husband and wife. It's going to element of, in fact, destruction today. There are some people are even doing that. Let us impregnate you. By the time she gets impregnated, the father who didn't want to see that boy before will be the one looking for him. This is fitna. This is fitna. What the fitna? La tusibanna alladhina dhalamu minkum khassan. Fair fitna. It is not at our door. That's number one. One of the causes of 50-50 syndrome. A man will now go helter skelter to get everything. By the time they put in the car, I say, now, alhamdulillah, of all men, I have gotten you. In my house, you pay this, I pay that. Because perhaps what he has taken loans even to get the nikah done. That's number one. Number two, another concept in our tradition, which was never known, not seen, not practiced by Professor Sandam. Nagenazu. That's another concept. Kaya list, endless list. Endless list. The nikah is not taking place at all. Go and bring 10 cartons of indomie, 10 cartons of spaghetti, 10 cartons of milk, 10 cartons of this, in some cases, ram, cow, just to give your daughter out. Allahu Akbar. Something Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. Majanan with ruqsa, and he said it, the best of all sadaqa, mahar, dowry, is aisaruha. Simple. Because that's what will attract more barakah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But kaya nasu, nageli nasu, kaya lewe, all these demands are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do based on your own ability. Liyunfi kudu sa'atin, min sa'atin. Let him spend from what Allah has given to him. He who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives abundantly. Woman kudira alayhi rizku, whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala measures low for him. Let him also spend with what Allah has given to him. If when you got married in your own time, you were not a millionaire, why will you now make it a subject today that if your daughter is bringing somebody, the person must be an average staff of NNPC, not even a new entrant? Can we all get to work in NNPC? But we must all marry, otherwise they will continue, the fitna will continue. The fitna will continue. She must bring somebody from this and that. You will not list, some have the list of all the high-paying prestatas, FIRC, this and that. If I've not mentioned the whole, I don't know. But the most important thing is that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, in ja'akum man qaddara dinahu wa khulqahu fazawwiju. When a man approaches you, comes to you, knock your door, and you are okay with his religion, do the background check, is from a good family background, you can even engage your son-in-law or his son-in-law to be. Give him job. He wants him to be in NNPC. Maybe he has gone to university and he has good degree. Collect his certificate and take him to NNPC. But don't make it, don't coerce him into saying, you sign an agreement, that's not something. I want to believe it's still online, not something reality. That you have to sign. A man insisted that you have to sign that you will not marry another one under or above my daughter. Who are you? Who are you? Who is your daughter? Are you up to the rank of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam married the best of human beings to him was Aisha. After Aisha, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam married another 5 women. Another 5. But don't marry 5. Your own matna wa thulatha wa ruba. Don't go beyond 4. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam min shama'ilihi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Part of the exclusiveness of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah gave him the opportunity, he didn't give any other person. May Allah make it easier for all of us. Part of these problems is that when you do the nikah, at the end of the day, there are a lot of things that you don't consider. That makes us to land is this 50-50 syndrome. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, at that advice, for the bar be that you do, tell what you are that. Try to choose based considering religion. If you are a religious person and you get a religious sister, inshallah, you'll be on the same page. You have seen in this country. A little way in this country, a sister happened to be a daughter of a big wig under Obasanjo regime. I know the sister, I know the man under Obasanjo regime. And the man said, no, this is the kind of brother you are going to bring to me? Never. Because he's the right hand man, close, one of the closest people to Obasanjo. And the sister insisted, based on Sunnah, because she's an Ijabia sister. And the father said, no, I have to look for maybe from one of the ministers or this and that. Then, no, this is the brother of mine. Today they have children, alhamdulillah. If you are religious and you look for religious as sister, don't look at those who make all this packaging. On the TikTok, everything, TikTok. If you take a wife from TikTok, TikTok will help you to divorce that woman. That is it. May Allah Taala forgive our shortcomings. Then what you are likely to do, and in fact, him and herself. The little you have, spend on your women. Don't lie to her before you bring her in. What you are not up to, don't tell her. What you are not up to, don't tell her. If that's the kind of thing she is looking for, then let her go. Because you will never have peace. You will never have peace. Yes. Because you didn't even marry Islamia. You married a party. And you saw her from that day, spaghetti. Indomie. No way, babe. The chest is outside. Part of the body outside. Now they were saying, man, Allah, tell me that I do. Yes. The Allah said, I'll forgive my shortcomings. Number three is that, don't be a source of victim to your wife. Even if she's offending you, talk to her. Find the room. As Allah says, pray to her. Why do you run after my Lord again? Try to separate. Leave her in her bed. If that is not wrong, then what do you do now? How do you do that? Scold her. Did you not do this? Haven't you did this? Haven't I done all this for you? Hey, I dear somebody. Hey, don't let Allah SWT come in between you and I. And after everything, as Allah SWT said, you have done your own best, she remains adamant. Then let her go. She may not be good for you, she may be good for another person. But in the case of 50-50, ma'azallahu bi amisultan, 70-30, it is your own sunnah. 40-60, it's your own sunnah. Sunnah of Allah is that you give your wife food, you give her clothes, you give her house, you give her everything based on what Allah has given to you as provision. May Allah make it easier for all of us. Alhamdulillah, let the power of the Jalla ala Nisa. ليسكنوا إليهن وجعل بينهم مودة ورحمة وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث رحمة للعالمين لإتمام مكارم الأخلاق صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله أنوار الإسلام وأصحابه أحرار الإيمان وكل من عاش على منهجهم إلى قيام الساعة بارك الله لكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا إياكم في ملائكة الذكر الحكيم أقول ما تسمعون سؤال فإن الله بين خطا فرد نفسي وهوايا واستغفر الله ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب الناس ومالكه ومدبر شؤون عباده شرع لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله الذي جاءنا بالكتاب كالشمس في ضحاها وجاءنا بسنه كالقمر اذا تلاها فمن عمل بهما عاش في نور النهار اذا جلاها ومن اعرض عنهما تخبط في ظلمه الليل الى يغشاها. معاشر المسلمين تدبروا قول المصطفى الحبيب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حيث يقول استوصوا بالنساء خيرا وقال المصطفى عين صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم لاهله وانا خيركم لاهلي. وقد قال المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم امرا ومؤدبا لامته صلى الله عليه وسلم يا معشر الشباب تنكى المراه لاربع لجمالها ولدينها ولحسبها ولمالها فاظفر بذات الدين تربت يداك اذا سافرت بذات الدين تكون شاكرا لله سبحانه وتعالى. عباد الله ان الله امركم امرا بدا من نفسه وثنى بملائكته حول عرشه وثلث بكم الانس والجن وقال وذا من قائل ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وسلم. عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر كيد اعداء الدين واصرف عبادك الموحدين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل الامن والامان فينا نيجيريا واجعلها بلدا امنا مطمئنا رقاء سقاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك قوم الى صلاتكم رحمكم الله.